For now, what we know is that the aircraft has lost contact with the Jakarta air traffic control at 6:15 local time, so almost 6 hours ago. And contact was lost only 42 minutes after the plane took off from Surabaya. A Transport Ministry official, Hadi Mustafa, said the plane had asked for an unusual route before it lost contact, and he now believes the plane was in between the islands of Kalimantan and Java when it happened. On board of this plane, there are 162 passengers, including 7 crew members. A nationality on board include people from Indonesia, Malaysia, Korea, Singapore, and the UK. Air Asia Airlines posted the following statement on their Facebook page regarding the missing aircraft. At the present time, they unfortunately have no further information regarding the status of the passengers and the crew members on board, but they will keep all parties informed as more information becomes available. At this time, search and rescue operations are in progress, and Air Asia is cooperating fully and assisting the rescue service. And they also have established an emergency call center.
Well, the White House are now saying that Obama has been briefed on this missing flight. Of course, as Claire was saying, details still coming in. We will keep you updated on that developing story throughout the morning.
Information on this at the moment, but the Reuters news agency are saying that an Air Asia flight travelling from Indonesia's Surabaya to Singapore has lost contact with air traffic control. That's coming to us via the Reuters news agency, and they're quoting an Indonesian news channel. So Surabaya in Indonesia itself, that's where the flight began, and it was on its way to Singapore. It's an Air Asia flight, and it has lost contact with air traffic control. That's the breaking news we've got at the moment. No more detail, but of course, as soon as we do get any other information, we'll bring that to you here first at Sky News. Information on this at the moment, but the Reuters news agency are saying that an Air Asia flight travelling from Indonesia's Surabaya to Singapore has lost contact with air traffic control. That's coming to us via the Reuters news agency, and they're quoting an Indonesian news channel. So Surabaya in Indonesia itself, that's where the flight began, and it was on its way to Singapore. It's an Air Asia flight, and it has lost contact with air traffic control. That's the breaking news we've got at the moment. No more detail, but of course, as soon as we do get any other information, we'll bring that to you here first at Sky News. In the meantime,
it's one of the most successful, one of the safest, one of the best loved aircraft, not only by airlines, but also by passengers. So what I'm seeing at the moment, it's a fly-by-wire cockpit. It's extremely modern. This particular aircraft that we're talking about tonight, if it's the one that I think it is, you're looking at a plane 6 years old. So it's not an old aircraft. It's being flown by an extremely reputable airline with a very good reputation for safety.
All right, our Richard Quest, CNN Aviation correspondent. Do stand by for us, Richard. We will come back to you shortly, because I want to bring in Derek Van Dam, our meteorologist, who's standing by with more. Obviously, a question on the minds of many as they hear, Derek, that the pilot reportedly requested a change in the route will be the weather. What can you tell us about what the weather was like in that region at the time? This plane lost contact 7:24 a.m. local time Sunday.
All right, Aisha. Well, it is the middle of monsoon season across this part of the world, and normally thunderstorms or convection don't quite start bubbling up until we get the daytime heating from the sun, so typically towards the afternoon. But we have looked at the latest satellite, which we'll show you in just 1 second, and it has been extremely busy weather-wise across this area. In fact, we've been covering very heavy rain and flooding across the border of Malaysia and Thailand for the past 24 to 48 hours, but obviously this is an unrelated topic. This is the flight path taking place from Surabaya to Singapore with Air Asia Flight 850. And you can see just how far it made it before, across the Java Sea, before it lost contact. Now, if we go to the next slide, you'll see the exact same area. This is the Java Sea. Here's Singapore. Here's Surabaya. And you can see just how active the thunderstorms are across this region. Didn't matter that it was at 7:15 in the morning. We still had lines of very heavy thunderstorms, obviously giving the pilot good reason to redirect their route as they were flying north towards Singapore. But keep in mind that turbulence doesn't necessarily bring down an airplane. It usually leads to other human factors. We recall the Air France tragedy back in June of 2009. That was attributed to some form of bad weather, and unfortunately the pilot did make an error in rerouting the plane around the thunderstorm that developed, ultimately taking down the Air France plane. Now, of course, this is all speculatory of what's actually taking place. All of the information is so new with this particular instance here for AirAsia. But there's one thing for certain. This is a very active weather pattern across this part of the world. In fact, you can see this moisture flow that's just coming down from the South China Sea. This is a northeasterly wind that builds up all kinds of moisture. And then it reaches Singapore into Malaysia and Thailand, very mountainous part of the world. It takes that moisture, cools it, condenses it, and helps form those thunderstorms. And if the thunderstorms move across the Java Sea, where the plane was traversing, keep in mind there's a lot of updrafts with thunderstorms, and that can really throw around airplanes quite easily. We recall that, or call that turbulence, of course. And so this is our concern going forward, that the recovery efforts, if this is the case, is going to be hampered by additional bad weather. You can see just how active our precipitation forecast is across Singapore, and just to the south we have lots of rainy conditions and thunderstorms moving through the region. Again, this is monsoon season. We expect this type of weather this time of year, but it has just been consistent. In fact, we have rainfall totals going forward over the next 2 days upwards of 100 millimeters near Singapore. So definitely bad weather, speculative, but certainly could have been a factor in the disappearance of this plane.
And Derek, let me just ask you before I let you go about the water conditions in that area, what you know at this stage. Of course, we do not know what has happened to this AirAsia flight that went missing from Indonesia to Singapore, but Mary Schiava was pointing out that, you know, this was an area with quite rough currents. What can you tell us about water depths? Just give us some sense of the lay of the land.
Okay, well, this is a very deep ocean across this part of the world, but one thing's for certain, when we get convective thunderstorms that develop thanks to the monsoon season across this area, it doesn't take much for the outburst of a thunderstorm to push up the waves and create very choppy conditions. So not only is the cloud cover overhead and the persistent rain and perhaps thunder and lightning hampering some of the efforts across that region, we've got to remember that on the ocean, if there are boats traveling to the last point of contact of this particular AirAsia plane, waves could be very choppy. And we're talking about 2, 3, even 4 meter waves possible with some of this wind swept ocean currents from the thunderstorms moving through. Aisha.
All right, Derek Van Dam, closely monitoring this for us from CNN's International Weather Center. Derek, we appreciate it. Do stand by for us. If you were just joining us, we want to reset and tell you about the breaking news coming into us here at CNN that an AirAsia flight en route from the Indonesian city of Surabaya to Singapore is missing. An Indonesian transport official tells CNN flight 8501 lost contact with air traffic controllers early Sunday morning. To be precise, we are told that it lost contact at 7:24 a.m. Sunday morning local time. Now, the pilot reportedly requested an unusual route before the plane lost contact. The airline says a crisis center has been set up and search and rescue operations are underway. There are reports as many as 162 people are on board that Airbus 320. We want to put up a shot on our screen so you can see the aircraft, the type of aircraft that we're talking about. We have a picture of that Airbus 320. That's the kind of plane we're talking about, an Airbus 320. Indonesian TV reports that most of those on board this flight were Indonesians, are Indonesians, I should say, with three Koreans, one passenger from Singapore, one from the UK, and one from Malaysia, all on board. Now, we are standing by for a statement from the Malaysia